Let's see if article number 3, which is from martechadvisor.com, let's see if these guys have anything extra to say. So the article is called "The State of Localized Programmatic: Why Marketers Need to Adapt a Personalized Digital Strategy." And actually, I think this article is mostly about the geolocation-based marketing rather than localization per se. But since I already selected this article, I'll try to at least pick something interesting. So, the explosion of personalization, and that's what we just talked about in article number 2. Every marketer knows that customers expect a personalized experience, but where did it all begin? A good bet would be the smartphone. These personal devices forever redefine how people find information and purchase goods and services, and in turn provided another avenue for advertisers to reach individual customers. The daily lives of consumers have changed, with most people spending more than 5 hours a day on mobile devices, and for marketers to succeed, they need to meet the consumer where they are, which happens to be on their smartphones. Mobile phones are one of the greatest resources for personalization due to the ubiquitous, I don't know the word, use of location services and location data. This data provides marketers highly targeted insights in order to reach the right consumer at the right time in the right place. In 2018, programmatic mobile ad spend in the US grew 25% from $24 billion the year prior. Mobile will soon account for around 78% of the $46 billion programmatic ad market. Location intelligence also makes the online to offline connection more transparent and allows marketers to track the ROI for personalized location-based targeting. According to data from Simplify, location-based mobile targeting solutions drove an average 391% increase in incremental physical site visits for clients from target areas, as reported by GeoConversion Lift in 2018. Advertisers need to embrace measurements that relate to sales and push their partners to adopt conversion-based metrics so that they can track how mobile advertising spend has impacted their business. The use of mobile and the resulting power of location-based targeting sits at the center of a massive industry-wide shift in the way marketers deliver targeted ads. Location-based intent data helps marketers go beyond targeting on things like cookies and search data and precisely reach the right consumer based on how they have interacted with both the digital and physical world together. Next, what are the growth areas in localized programmatic? For marketers to understand which programmatic mobile strategies are working and optimize these strategies in real time, geofencing, addressable geofencing, and OTT CTV have emerged as the leading trends in the state of localized programmatic. Geofencing. The entry point for many advertisers into localized marketing is geofencing. Geofencing is a location-based mobile advertising technology that utilizes latitude and longitude data to target specific geographical areas. These data sources and filtering models ensure highly accurate GPS data so that advertisers can reach individuals based on the locations they're in or have visited previously. Advertisers have been quick to adopt this targeting tactic, and it has largely been responsible for swaying national advertisers to invest in localized mobile ad spend. The second one is addressable geofencing. One of the largest growth areas for localized programmatic is addressable geofencing. Addressable geofencing is a revolutionary way to target specific households and businesses with digital advertising, such as mobile, video, and or OTT CTV ads. Addressable geofencing is the next logical step in the localization and personalization of programmatic advertising. The solution uses split line and GPS data rather than IP-based targeting to deliver programmatic advertising to specific households from first-party databases or curated lists based on various demographic targeting variables. Finally, OTT and CTV advertising. As new consumer TV viewing habits shift towards stream content, it is becoming more important than ever for marketers to incorporate CTV advertising into their marketing strategies. In fact, streaming video subscriptions have now surpassed cable subscriptions worldwide for the first time. In response, programmatic has seen an incredible amount of budget shifting this year as TV buyers rearrange their linear budgets to test the reach and frequency, along with the targeting capabilities, analytics, and attribution that come with CTV advertising. This is most certainly the space to watch, and it looks like streaming content is not only here to stay, but is poised to continue taking over the video content market. So I don't have much to add here, or let me think. So the first thing that comes to mind is geofencing. And I actually did hear about geofencing from this channel that I think I started. I subscribed to that channel. It's Grant Cordone. He's like a super sales guy, super rich, I guess. And I somehow found his content, and I think that when I did my very first attempt to do a vlog, I even mentioned it there, because in his videos, which is kind of like a motivational speech that he gave to his sales staff, was that most of the people work 9 to 5. If you want to achieve something, you need to work from 5 to 9. So that's something that I try to do, and I kind of like still try to do it, you know. It's basically like, if you're not sleeping, then try to do something productive and get somewhere. So, and actually from his channel, I discovered Gary Vaynerchuk, who is now my main YouTube content creator that I watch. So, and going back to geofencing, so at some point on his channel, they started like a new series, which is called Lead Magnet with... what is his name? Kern? Some Kern guy? He's like a marketer. So he's not like a sales guy, like a Grant, but he's like a marketer. So he talks a lot about digital advertising and stuff like that. So he mentioned geofencing. So I know that kind of works, like you can like really target like people who are like, I don't know, let's say 25, 50 meters like around your actual store. So that's where the offline and online world kind of like collide, and you can have a better better metrics and analytics on your advertising versus like when you just compare it to, let's say, a billboard or something like that. And OTT CTV advertising, I guess that's like advertising on the streaming platforms, I would assume. And maybe that one can be also very geo-specific and highly targeted. So how would this actually tie to localization? That's a good point, because I think it's kind of similar to what the previous article talked about, which is more about personalization based on the consumer habits, or like what they did and how they interacted like with your site, what they're like searching for in Google. This is more about the location-based advertising. But in any case, I think if you have like a specific, maybe if you have like, I don't know, let's say like your store is on like a certain street, and you wanna, I don't know, send a message or like display an ad like, hey, if you're on the street, let's say Homer Street, feeling thirsty, or yeah, well, how about like, feeling thirsty on Homer Street, come for lemonade or something like that. So that would be kind of like the source text, but the idea is that this whole principle, like with the super personalized messages, that can also be based on the geolocation, then it need to be localized. So I think there's again a lot of room for transcreation. And if we are like leveraging all this data that the user is providing us through some variables, which is kind of like related to internationalization, technically, you think about it, your message should not be like fixed, but it should also probably have variables that come that are kind of like completed based on the data that the user provides and that you get from different platforms. So actually, you think about it, it kind of like interferes even with the first article, which was about internationalization. So how would you internationalize your marketing messages so that they are robust and they can deal with this hyper personalized and geo-based targeting?